so maybe to be interesting in that module. So we talk about the SCALDE module this afternoon, and after we do questions. So let's first introduce ourselves. You may have noticed we are French, so sorry in advance for the accent. This is Olivier.
Hi, I'm Olivier Fries. I work in Radio France, French public group radio. I'm also French Drupal president of the Drupal Association.
Yeah. French. And it was at Drupal on Twitter. And I am Simon Moreau. I am the CEO of OWS. We are a medium Drupal shop in France. We've been running for 12 years. And we've been doing exclusively 100% Drupal since 4.6 version, so we are kind of Drupal specialists in France. And my Twitter is standard.
I don't believe you've got too much hair.
the history of this module, which is the SCALDE module, we started in 2008 with this D6 version. It was designed by an American company, which was called CTC. Then these guys left the module and the company, and so we continued to develop it with Radio France sponsoring and by OWS. It was the main goal of this module. It was to be able to manage media, every kind of media. We'll see that later. Usability part for many contributors, many journalists, and many end users. And also being able to provide a community solution for big multimedia sites.
It's an important choice for Radio France to have mainstream modules in all installations. So SCALDE module is also a contributed module. Very important.
It's been so close, yeah, from the beginning. And we decided to port it on Drupal 7 in 2012, last year, so it's been 1 year and it's kind of working now. As for the adoption, for the D6 version, there were big users, mainly Radio France, but few users, like 10 or 20 users. Why? Because at this time there were no entity in Drupal, so SCALDE had to bring that its own version of entity, and it was very hard to understand for people and for developers and for site builders. The US design was very, very poor, I'll show you just after, and there were less community work. We didn't communicate, we didn't make conferences about this module, so now this has changed since the 7 version. We can see,
you are very sure,
you want to see. So this was the D6 design, D6 version. This was the multimedia library.
Bracket plus in the bracket.
So button.
Yes.
So it was made for coders by coders, so there wasn't so much success. And then after we hired a UX engineer and designer, it became this, much more usable, and we'll make you some demos after that.
We are good time.
Yeah, with real pictures. It changes a bit. And as for D7, now we have more users, more and more users. It's been totally redesigned. Now it takes advantage of entities, so it's mainstream. And you've just seen the UX redesign. And there is a lot of community work. I forgot to ask you, as we started, who knows this module? Who has ever installed this module? And who has written a provider for this module?
Right.
Nice to meet you. It's not a joke, we've never met. And so now the main known users are big media companies, French companies, because we are French. but now we are trying to get an international audience. So there is France Télévisions, which is the national TV in France. Arte, too, is one of the national TVs in French. Radio France, French. French and Germany, Arte, yes. The French government on some of its sites. Africa 24, which is an African channel. We didn't know, but we saw a developer who said there is Calde on this instance. And Radio Nova, which is a small radio, but a cool radio in France. And maybe you can add some use cases or some references. I don't know for who you install this module.
And we are
we use the British Council.
I don't know if that's the reason.
Okay, nice. So the British Council. So you must ask what does Calde for those who don't know the module. So the main goal is to manage all your digital assets on Drupal. And when we mean assets, it can be images, sounds, videos, you know that. But this can be files, this can be tweets. Tweets are not files, but you want to embed tweets in some of your notes. So you can be tweets. This can be Facebook statuses, and this can be everything you can think of when you think about assets. So the main goal is to allow a user to use and reuse these assets in Drupal objects, that means in nodes, in users, in taxonomies, in entities, because everything is fieldable, and SCAD works with field API, so you can use it everywhere. And we want it to be very simple, so you can do it with drag and drop and a unique interface. It allows you to easily share and search between contributors all of these assets. And yeah, it looks like media, in the media module. At first, we asked if we wanted to merge with the media module, but it has a different approach, because media is based on a file-centric approach. That means every media has to be a file. Therefore, you cannot say a digital asset is a tweet or a Facebook status. So the approach is not the same, and we decided to port this module to this area. So the main concept of Scalde is the atom. An atom is a single digital asset. Mainly it has a provider, because it can be a file, you can upload a video, but it can be an external source, because you can get your video from YouTube, Dailymotion, Vimeo, whatever you want, or MPEG, or I don't know. It can be a SoundCloud for a sound, or it can be a file for a sound. It has a thumbnail, which is the single image representation of the atom. It has author and tags, which are built-in taxonomies. And it has everything an entity can have in D7. That means you can field an atom and say, my atom image, I want it to have a link file, and every kind of field you can think of with field API. It has its own cloud system, which is very important. And Scalde offers a cache system. So performance was also target for this module, because on the sites, we need to have cache. Yes. More than the cache. Then the main concept of Scalde is the library, which is the library that every contributor can use, and that you can see on any edit page. So basically, it's an interface to search and create and use atoms. The good thing and the good news is that it's a view, so you can extend it the way you want on your site implementation. And maybe we can do a demo right now to see what we're talking about. So this is a site on simplytest.me. So we only have 20 minutes left. Every node, and you see this right bar here.
This is the library, and you can see all the different media you have already inserted. You have produce,
these are the views export pictures, and this is the view results. So with views, you can build whatever you want. This is the default view provided with the module. So let's say you don't want these features, or you want to provide other features. You have preview, nice preview. You have search. You can refine your search. Your search is remembered here. And so this is the main point of the library, and it comes on every node edit page, on every maybe user edit page, on everything you activated this module. And then from the library, you can also add atoms, and we'll see that just after. So the module also provides a field using field API, which is called atom reference, which is a really simple field where you can drag and drop atoms to use them for many usages. Remember node reference and user reference, it's exactly the same but with atom, or exactly the same as entity reference, but it has something more, so we didn't use entity reference. So one use case can be, let's say, a video wall. You create a node, a content type that is a video wall, and you want your contributors to drag and drop every video and order them into a nice wall. So, too small resolution. That's the simply test effect. So just drag and drop your media here. You can restrict the type of media you want to drag and drop. And so for a video wall, you drag and drop 10 videos, and that's it.
Is there a reason why that's not a widget for entity reference field?
Yes, because of the rendering you have there. And the top level of rendering we put over when drag and dropping. This could not be done with entity reference. And the other thing was, when we started this project, put it on Drupal 7, entity reference wasn't very much stable.
Yes. So this is only useful for assets that already exist. If you wanted to add new images to this node,
oh, yes. You can do that. No, you have this part of the library with a small plus, which allows you to create every kind of asset you want using model frame. So let's do this. Maybe with an image, you can. So you can see for image, you have two providers activated here, but they can be three or four. We have the image upload, which we are going to use now. And you also have this new module, Scale the Flickr, when you can get your image from Flickr, from a user stream or a text stream. So you... So you automatically get your thumbnail, and then you can add offers, you can add tags. And below is the CRUD system I've told you about. And then you just get back your image there, and you can drag and drop it directly. So the contributor doesn't have to load any page or change page to add a new asset.
So is that image belong to that node?
No. It belongs to the atom system. But when you drag and drop it, then it comes an element of the node, just like you would do for a node reference.
So if you did a node load, that image would be in that node object.
Yeah. And it can be in a atom reference field, but it can also be in the WYSIWYG field, I will show you just after. So you saw the atom reference, which is a simple use case, but the main thing of this module is it works with WYSIWYG. So it works with any text area film in Drupal. Both works with WYSIWYG, the module, which is the API to make it work with, let's say, TinyMC. And now it works with CK Editor, which is the Drupal 8 way from January now. Drupal has decided to integrate it into code. So we made an effort on making it function with the CK Editor module, so it works. This guy just behind me is a bit responsible for that. Theodore. And so let's do the D&D demo. So here is your article. Maybe it's because it's on simply test with the JS port over it. Maybe. Okay, so let's see another instance. I'm not used to say bad things about Max, but sometimes PC is better.
you can play the agenda video. The WYSIWYG
maybe if it doesn't work after on that, we will switch from the final demo. So, as for the providers, and also the atom types, because you have atom types, which are video, audio, image, and providers, which provide atoms. The existing ones are video, so you can get video from Vimeo, YouTube, Dailymotion, Keep Digital, which is it's a big video company, you know, I don't remember its name. It was developed by Smile, which is a medium IT shop in France. Vidler, thanks for Vidler. And Embedly is on its way, so with Embedly you can get video from almost every source. Some I don't want to talk about. You have sounds. You can get sounds from file, but you can also get sounds from SoundCloud. Which is really cool. You can get sounds and you can get playlists from SoundCloud. As for image, you can get image file and you can get your images from Flickr. We also provide Flash, the way to embed Flash into your content. Twitter, Facebook, you can get Facebook statuses. And the good thing is that every developer can implement its own module based on the API, and you can make your own provider. There are very well documented examples, and you can every source of media you think of, you can make a provider with. So I
yeah.
this was time for demo. Maybe you can switch. There was no use case now for implementing that, but as long as you use entities and there is a strong API and you can define new objects, we can do that.
So let's try to build an image here. Okay, I'm very, very sorry about that.
Is there a way to disable the automatic reading? Is there a way to disable the automatic reading?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Good question.
Yeah.
So maybe we can get a video from YouTube to show you how very simple it is. So you choose a provider, then you just have to paste the URL. And you get automatically the thumbnail from YouTube. And you also get the tags.
When you've got thousands, I mean, for a small number of assets, that works really well. When you've got thousands of assets, does the user interface scale well with thousands of assets?
Yeah, that's exactly the use case at Radio France.
Right.
And because it is a view, you can use features and you can refine your search.
Okay.
You can also use views, save searches, which allows users to define the default search results.
Yeah.
So I say a journalist, he wants every image only with that tag because he's a sport journalist. So he saves sports in tags, and every time he comes to edit a node, by default he has only the old videos and images because he can choose every tag.
So it's really well proven against large asset bases.
Yes, because it's only a few results, so you can say there are 5 results by default, but if you want 10 and you want to make a bit of CSS to make that a little bit smaller, you can also do that.
When you're doing videos, can you set points? So can you set the video to start only at 1 minute or 1 second?
Yes, it's a bit... you have a rendering engine across Scarlett, which you can, there's an abstraction for players, so you can say in that context, like in the teaser context, you can use that player, so you can add a property to the entity and get the property from the video, which is a start and a number of seconds, and then you can, when you call the TPF, you can just insert it.
Okay, so that's on a template basis, not a user basis.
No. After that, we will show you how to edit inside the WYSIWYG the properties of an atom, so you can extend that way also.
Is it?
This is the way you know how to tweet.
Sylvain. Sylvain?
Oui.
We saw that
where the data are pulled out from. Can you configure the destination for the uploads?
Yes, when you make a provider, you code that. You say it has to be stored there, and you define your own storage, so you can use you can code every storage you want using the power of field of the other.
What would be the best way to integrate this with an external asset library that you may already have that's not in Drupal? What would be the best way to go about putting it into this?
I think the simplest way I think of is building a migrate class and importing large amounts of data into the library. After that, you can maybe write a provider that will like we do on Flickr, that will allow your users to first search into this large amount of data, and then pick one, and then click on import, and then it will go through like.
When you put in things like tweets, do you get sort of control over if you have the tweet image and the text, or can you set it so you just
have
the text?
There is a template for that. So when you give the basic information, you can, after that, you can template your rendering of the here is a default template provided by Twitter, but you can do whatever you want. So same for videos, and you can say that uploaded video file. We just saw Vimeo, YouTube, and Dailymotion, which are hosted video files, but you can write a provider that will allow you to transcode your video, and then use a player like JW Player, and render it just the way you want. Yes?
How does the copyright management work? Can you attach like a Creative Commons license to the images that you bring?
Yes. In DD6, there used to be a licensing part which was integrated into the module, but now we separated it, and to implement it we use taxonomies. So when you have an atom, an image atom, you just create a licensing taxonomy, and then you can do almost whatever you want using rules and using some custom code to convert the license. In Drupal 6, we handle the expiration of licenses, like images, they have 30-day use, and after that you have to unpublish the node while you put it. And this was done, but now we consider that this can be done just writing a small amount of code and using taxonomies, so it's not right in module. But it's pretty easy to implement.
So the license starts with the right, or in French, doing time.
That's hard, right?
In the day.
Yeah,
protection.
Here you have different types of licenses, and you say for the AFP, which is a big French press agency, there was a 30-day limit to use it. And then you show at the end of the use what to do, just not displaying it or just unpublish the sentence.
Okay. Moodox Park. Radio France believe in the park distribution and sponsor the backport of the Drupal 8 to Drupal 7 Spark initiative, and they work from with Theodore work from integrate Scalde in edit module. We provide online editing, inline editing on your website, and also we are work on cut and paste functionality directly in the CK editor. You can cut your atom and go on the place and paste your.
Maybe if you want, because we do not have much
yes.
anymore, we've set a Bird of Feather session just after that. So if you want to come and see more in details of interactions on the live screen, you can come and we can show you edit and cut and paste and every kind of provider you want to
see the demo.
It is a list of the different beginning points from start with Scandi and the roadmap.
So the roadmap is very simple. We need more providers. So at AWS, every 2 weeks we iterate on sprints, and providers come out of that. So they will soon be released. But if you have providers or like this one did learn and it's working and you want it to be published, we can assist you and we will be glad to. The 1.0 version will be out before Parker because we want to show it at the Parker. And the next features will be more close integration with the edit module because this is the future of the content of Parker in Drupal. More CK editor features because as it has been chosen for the 8, it's the way to go. And new UX improvements. The UX designer is coming back to work with us, so it's a great thing. And the goal is to be in D9 core, D3, but it's a nice goal. And then we need you, all of you, you can come and contribute to this module. Many people are doing so. There is an TV show where you, if you see any bug, just like the one you noticed there. The documentation is really well written, so don't hesitate. And we hope to get providers from all of the world and maybe exotic ones. And you, use it, talk about it, and try it, test it. Maybe implement it maybe on your side. Mm-hmm. Yes?
I just think you've got the advantage of being able to add things that aren't files, like tweaks. What are the other big advantages over the user module?
Maybe this one. At first, it was the UX design. You don't have this UX design on the module.
It's a nice interface.
Just maybe in the last version, I've seen something similar. And it's we are not happy with the file entity approach. You know, it's very limiting. And it's the example of tweets, it's the example of Facebook, but it's also the example of YouTube videos. You know, there is no path for YouTube video, it's on YouTube, so you have to work around when you implement media. And with that, you don't have to work around. But anyway, we're not against media, it's another way to. Manage media in a good way also, but this is 3 years of work and we hope to throw it away.
Yeah.
Maybe we wanted to merge with media at one time, but it was too, these approaches were too different, so we cannot make a merge. Do you have any more questions? Okay, so thank you for listening to.
No, 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 no,